Hello, all my fellow barbecue enthusiasts. Mike Baker here of Baker's Barbecue. Hey, today we're going to fire up that new Oklahoma Joe's Bronco. And then we're going to spatchcock two chickens, hang them, and we're going to let them cook. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to light the Oklahoma Joe's Bronco up. And I want to show you, first of all, how we did the charcoal pan. It takes a little bit longer to set this up than a normal charcoal smoker. If you want to set that pan up right to be able to get as long of a cook time as you can out of it. So instead of just dumping charcoal in there, I actually took a little bit of time, put it into some sort of formation with some wood chunks in there, and I'm getting ready to light it up. I think it holds, it says about 8 pounds. I think I got probably closer to 10 pounds in it. So as you can see, we got the charcoal down in there. This charcoal pan here is full of about close to 10 pounds of charcoal. I'm going to light from this end right here and let it go about 15, 20 minutes. It will slowly start burning and make its way all the way across this pan. It's supposed to get 10 hours plus in cook time. I don't think the chicken's going to take anywhere near that time, but I went ahead and set the pan up today to test the time. In addition to cooking the chicken. So here we go. Now I'm just going to adjust the damper wide open, let that start smoking and come up to temp by about 20 minutes. All right, so we've taken the chicken and did what's called the spatchcock method, which is where you cut out the backbone and then flip it over and break the breastbone to make it flexible. We're gonna open up. So we got it all shook down. We used some strawberry shake, which is a local favorite here in Missouri. And we're gonna get them hanging here shortly. And so we got the chicken on. Temperature showing here at about 240. And my ink bird is showing about 268. So sometimes it takes these thermometers a little bit of time to calibrate and break in, but I've also heard that this thermometer is sometimes off pretty considerable. So we'll take a quick look and then we'll shut it back down. That's how she's looking. I don't know about you guys, but I absolutely love looking at a smoker fired up and got some delicious barbecue on there. Pretty steady temp, showing 264 there. It's set between the one and the two, and the top damper is somewhere around that one. It does fluctuate around just a little bit. I'm still fine tuning it. And as you can see, the thermostat on the smoker is about 20 degrees different. So anyway, that's kind of where I'm at on the dampers, and we will keep watching it. Got it opened up here, just stuck some thermometers in there and give them a little spray here. Looking really good. I like the fact you can open those up and do that. So here we go, we're gonna shut her back down. Looking good. Looking good. Getting ready to take them off. They came, I let them come to about 172. It took all total about 3 hours and 15 minutes, somewhere in that range. I'd say it probably cooked at an average ambient temperature of around 260.